This is the long-awaited motorized vibrating shaker table sifter project, and I'm excited to be bringing it to you. This is Steve DeMossi, and welcome to Uncharted DIY. Stay tuned, and I'll show you why this is such a cool project and how you can make your own shaker table, too. This shaker table doesn't require any special knowledge or special tools, so it's easy to build. It would take too long to cover each step in detail in this video, so this shows you how it's built and how it operates. Detailed plans, cut list diagrams, and a step-by-step illustrated guide is available for this project. While I referred to this machine as a compost shaker table in the compost tumbler video, these devices have many names. Compost shaker table, sifter frame, motorized sieve screen, vibratory shaker, soil sifter, mechanical sifter, trommel tray, and many others. My point is these can be used for so much more than just compost. They're a big help for sifting soil and dirt to remove rocks, stones, and debris for making great topsoil. Some people use them to sift earthworms, some for removing debris from sandblasting media, some for finding arrowheads, relics, and shark teeth, wine production, gold separation, and you've probably seen them used for archaeological and paleontological digs. Commercial motorized shaker table sifters can be surprisingly expensive, but they make quick work of tough jobs. In the spirit of DIY, I decided to design and build my own. You can build one too, and it costs between $100 and $130 if you're buying all the nuts, bolts, and screws new. The wood is not included in that total due to the astronomical price of lumber as of late. I had much of the small hardware and fasteners already, including lumber, so mine came in at about $100 total. Besides sifting compost, one of the primary reasons we wanted one of these shaker tables is to process the biochar we make. Biochar is a charcoal-like, carbonized biomass that has numerous benefits, and we use ours for gardening. We make ours from waste wood, using a clean burning gasifier of my design. The wood burns in a low oxygen, superheated process called pyrolysis. Because our biochar is made from various types of wood waste, the resulting raw product comes out in a lot of different sized pieces, looking like this. We can't use such large pieces without further processing, so we use the shaker table to sift out any large pieces and crush those down to size separately. We repeat the sifting until it's all properly sized for the garden. The angle of this shaker table is adjustable to provide different processing speeds while it sifts and sorts to three different sizes. The first screen is 1/4 inch, so the vibration causes fine particles to drop into the first bin right away. Because the sifter tray is tilted, what doesn't fall through the first screen passes on to the second, 1/2 inch screen, and falls into its own bin. What doesn't fall through that screen goes off the end and into the third bin. The bins are simple, inexpensive mortar mixing tubs, and a modular design allows them to be easily replaced. Because the screen tray is a separate component, it's easy to make trays with different size mesh screens for processing various types of material with the same machine. So now that you know what this does, let's get into how to make this super useful machine. Normally I'd start with all new lumber since it looks nicer on camera, but given the current price of lumber, I decided to use what I had on hand. It isn't shiny and pretty, but structurally it's nice and solid. Even though I'll be covering this table when it's not in use, it's a good idea to use pressure-treated wood or redwood lumber to resist moisture and rot. Besides, the reciprocating saw can't handle being out in the weather. You can cover just the saw and protect it from the weather with a garbage bag and a couple of bungees. I'm using exterior screws to construct this machine so corrosion won't cause the frame to weaken and fail. I designed this so it can be made using basic tools, so don't worry if you don't have an advanced setup. The machine consists of three main components, and with the exception of a few particle board spacers and a 2x2 that supports the screens, it's made from 2x4 lumber. The base is where the bins go when in use, and it supports the pivots and tilt adjustment arms. This part features bracing to keep it stable and strong. The middle portion, or frame, is what's adjusted for tilt, and it's where the screen tray rides back and forth. It also supports the reciprocating saw, which acts as the motor that provides the back and forth vibration movement. The top component is the screen tray itself. This has two different size metal mesh screens attached for sorting and sifting. It rides on casters to minimize friction. It attaches to the reciprocating saw, and this tray is the part that does all the moving and shaking. Showing every detail of the construction in this video would take too much time, so I have detailed plans with a list of hardware specifications, a materials checklist, a cut list, and diagrams showing what cuts to make on each board to most efficiently cut the lumber to minimize cutoff waste. These plans also include a bonus video that offers additional detail and shows how to use alternate tools and techniques in case you don't have the same type of tools I used to build it. There's more information and a link in the description below. With these plans in hand and the materials ready to go, this awesome shaker table can be completed by most beginning DIYers in a weekend and less for those with more experience. The first step in making the shaker table is cutting the wood to size. These simple cuts could easily be made on a miter saw, handheld circular saw, or with a hand saw. I'm using a radial arm saw to make my cuts because for now it's the saw with the best dust collection in my shop. Using the cutting diagrams makes cutting the wood fast and easy, and these diagrams address using 8-foot or 10-foot lengths of 2x4s. The assembly is made using simple joinery, right angles, and all but two cuts are made at 90 degrees. To join the pieces, I'm using pocket holes for speed and for the strongest joints. If you don't have a pocket hole jig though, don't worry. This can also be done using simple butt joints and quality exterior wood screws. I show how to make butt joints in the bonus video included with the plans. I'm also using an impact driver instead of a drill driver because it's a big time saver, but you don't need one to make this table. The base is built first. Working on a flat surface will help to keep everything straight and square. Here, I'm using a couple of folding sawhorses and a piece of 3/4-inch medium density fiberboard, also known as MDF or particle board, as my work surface. The base of the shaker includes the uprights in the front, where the tilting frame pivots when adjusting the angle. It also includes the rear uprights, where the adjustment holes support the frame at the various degrees of tilt. It would be a great idea to use ground contact rated pressure treated lumber for this base part of the assembly, especially if it will sit in moist conditions or if it's stored outside. The base is sized to accommodate two of the catch bins within it. The bracing for the base is attached later, so with the bones of the base assembled, we can set it aside. Now we can move on to the frame section. This middle portion is the part that is tilt adjustable to alter the speed at which the material being sorted moves. This frame is where the sifting tray rides during its back and forth action. The attached arms have rollerball transfer bearings to constrain the tray and keep it in position from side to side. The frame also has space for the support that the reciprocating saw is attached to. The top component is the screen tray itself. This has two different size metal mesh screens attached for sorting and sifting. The screens are made from welded wire fencing, called hardware cloth, and they're attached with staples and a 2x2 center support. This tray rides on casters to minimize friction, and it's attached to the reciprocating saw. Since the tray is simple to make, it would be easy to build more than one, so you can have trays with different sized screens for different sized work. Once the main components are assembled, the final braces are added. It's best to brace the finished assembly since wood isn't always perfectly straight and might not be perfectly square when assembled. Finally, the saw is mounted to its support. This is the motorized part in motorized shaker table. I've designed this around the Chicago Electric reciprocating saw from Harbor Freight since it's inexpensive and it works really well. Other saws could be adapted to fit, but would probably need to be mounted a bit differently. This saw is mounted using a mending plate to hold down the front end of the saw and heavy-duty zip ties to keep it down on the support. The spacing of the 2x4s of the support locks the saw into position. To attach the reciprocating saw to the tray, I cut down a hose clamp and drilled some holes in it to create an adapter that fits into the reciprocating saw. This adapter clamps onto the eye bolt connected to the tray. I show how to do this in detail in the bonus video included with the plans. The speed of the saw is controlled by using an adjustable hose clamp. This squeezes the variable speed trigger and can adjust from a lazy shuffle to a full-blown earthquake. The tilt is adjusted with these two bolts, and no tools are needed to change things up. The wing nuts make it simple to remove the bolts for making the adjustments, yet tighten easily to keep the assembly nice and solid. By varying the degree of tilt and the rate of oscillation of the tray, the speed at which the material moves along the screen, and how fast the sifting and sorting takes place is adjustable. So now that you know how the shaker table screen sieve works, I'd love to hear what creative uses you might have for such a versatile machine. Let me know in the comments below or on the article page at UnchartedDIY.com. This is Steve, and thanks for watching Uncharted DIY. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe. Oh, come on, you're kidding me. I forgot the bin.